Hi everyone, welcome to another DaVinci Resolve tutorial. Today we're taking a look at a brand new Fairlight feature in Resolve 16.2 called the Edit Selection Mode. Here in Fairlight, we've got a couple of different modes you can use for editing. The first mode is the Selection Mode. It comprises of basic editing commands. It allows you to select, move, trim entire clips, The next mode is the range selection mode. And this is similar to the selection mode, but you can select a specific part or a range within a clip. You can also select a range across multiple clips within a track or across multiple tracks. You can select a range and you can delete that range. And the newest mode is the Edit Selection mode. It's a combination of those editing modes all in one tool. And it changes the editing based on the position of your mouse pointer. So if you hover on the upper half, it's the Range Selection tool you can see with the crosshairs. If you hover on the bottom half, it becomes a Grabber tool, which you can select, grab, move a clip. You can adjust the volume, you can trim your heads and tails. Additionally, it decouples your current time indicator from your editing. And that allows you to have super fast editing with your keyboard shortcuts while your timeline's still playing. Now, let me show you what that means. And I'll play the timeline. And see how the timeline bar, this orange bar, moves and this white indicator stays in place. That white indicator is your edit selection point. Now, the edit selection point is where I'm telling Resolve to make an edit at this point. And I'll use keyboard shortcuts for that. Now, before I do anything further, I want to make sure that I map some editing commands to my keyboard. I'll bring up my keyboard customization. I'm going to search for fading in and fading out. So I'll fade into playhead, I'll use Control D, and I'll fade out to playhead, and I'll use Control F. Additionally, trim start is a shift bracket, and that's default, and then a trim end is the shift right bracket. The other one I want to customize is trim to selection. I'll make trim to edit selection option T. Okay, I'll save it out as a new preset. So for now, this is the track that I'm going to do some edits to. So I will solo the track. So what I want to do is fade in and fade out. Fade in is Control D and fade out is Control F. So I'm going to select somewhere in the beginning and I want it to fade into this point. So I'll click to that moment and keyboard shortcut fade in, and I'll fade out later on. So I'm doing this the whole time this is playing back. So when I stop it, it goes back to the edit selection point and plays from that. All right, and you can hear it fade out. And let's say you wanted to trim the end to this point. I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut shift right bracket and trim the end. Now I can also move to other tracks and do some edits there. So I will find a point to do an edit. All right, this looks good, and I will trim the start. I can also select a range, and then I will trim my selection, option T, to that point. Now I'm gonna do a bunch of other edits here. Let me solo the other track so we can hear it. I'm just gonna play. Now I'm going to just continue to other tracks and make edits to it while this scene is playing back. So you can be watching and listening to your actual scene and making edits on the fly. So that's the edit selection mode, new in Resolve 16.2, a powerful new way of editing in Fairlight. If you like this video, please hit the subscribe button, and thanks for watching.